So we've all read in the newspaper about the Internet of Things, and the pundits are saying it's going to change our world. And there's really no doubt that it is. The main thing, though, is that people have totally underestimated the complexity of what we see coming. The issues of security, scale, and trust are leaving early adopters with systems that do not realize the promise or create technological dead ends. We evolve Pi over time and learned when and where different users run into these issues. We didn't know that as we improved how we collected real-time data, that we needed to confront and solve the issues that arise with IoT. But we did. So we're working today on an evolution of our systems. We call a community system. The first systems were really just a standalone system with terminals attached to them and hooked to an interface. Very quickly then, networking came about and we learned that we could have multiple computers that might be of use in the system. Then we moved to where people would want to put a system in every one of their facilities. So we had to deal with communication between facilities. The thing that is escalating here is the trust between the nodes. In the first case, you're all on the same node or even in the same computer, so the subject of trust never even comes up. In the second one, you're talking down a network that is owned by a single company, and so it's just really a convenience. On the third one, it starts to get a little more complex. You're dealing with computers that are on other networks that are talking to your network, so now you have to use communications that would go out, say, across a LAN to a LAN. Then we get to the ultimate, and that's systems that go out of your domain, they transit onto the internet, and they talk to other systems. And now it becomes much more difficult. We have to deal with IP addresses, VPNs, and the conventional mechanisms for security. IoT is going to be far more complex than that. These data are just going to want to come out of the spring and go into the cloud, and we're bringing them down and organizing who can use them and when they can use them. And this sounds good, but this takes a very different design of software. With the introduction of the community concept, we introduce a Pi infrastructure that shares data between customers and vendors, manufacturers and suppliers, consumers and power companies, universities and municipal agencies, or any combination thereof, plus environmental safety and health regulators. Think about things like smart cities, things like vendors manufacturing equipment and then maintaining it for you. You're now getting data transfer between two distinct legal entities. The community system requires, at the facility, all of the attributes we've been building into the Pi system for 30 years. Collect data from any source, store and organize the data at high throughput, do calculations, visualization, and programmatic access. There are differences, however. We have to deal with naming conventions, common storage of metadata, common display processors. Some users will need to have the data curated or inspected before sharing. Some data will need to be purposely delayed before delivery. The overall systems will span a much larger scale. The trust between nodes is different. The data sources tend to be much more distributed. Many of the entities that need to use the data will have no IT staff capable of managing a Pi system. We've already completed the first two pieces of this new infrastructure. One's called Pi Cloud Connect, which uses services to communicate. Thus, no point-to-point negotiation is required. And we built a new system to implement a storage of data in the cloud. So we're evolving, and we expect to evolve as we go. Our sense is that, like every time before, as we've increased the architecture, the value of these systems has gone up tremendously. We had a lot of value when we were a standalone system because we brought data to the eyes of people that had never seen it before. We brought it in real time, it was accurate, and they took action on it. We saw more value when we hooked it into multiple facilities within the same company, because now not only did the people at the facility have the data, the people that ran common to the facility had the data, whether that be an engineering group or a quality group or whatever. Then with the connected services, where we started sharing data between companies, we saw yet more value. You had data flowing to the manufacturers of your turbines and pumps and the people that really wanted you to be very successful. We expect the same to happen again, because the more data you have, the more value you can create from it. What we are charged with is building a system that will serve that market and grow robustly so that you can actually benefit from these values. Let us know where you see these applications, where you see the use of community systems benefiting you and your industry, and feel free to tell us how you see it helping your partners, your competitors, your customers, whoever. Let us hear from you, and I thank you very much for your time.